Hi, my name is Glenn Smyth, CEO and founder of Fragile to Agile. Welcome to the fifth video in our series on developing an outcomes and capability-driven roadmap for your organization's technology. If you haven't yet watched the overview video in this series, we recommend you do so. But by way of providing you context, this video covers the fifth step in this process, understanding the current state of your organization, the starting point for your journey, sufficiently and only sufficiently to map the journey to the target state, which we'll be defining in the next step. The current state should never be overcooked and should be right-sized for an organization's complexity, in particular, whether a qualitative or quantitative assessment is required. However, before we perform the actual assessment, we need to gather or catalogue the current technology solutions or applications in your organization. As everything we do is capability and outcomes-based, it should come as no surprise that we're going to capture and map the catalogue at the capability level and then overlay the solutions onto a business capability model, the one we developed in step two and covered in the second video in this series. An example of this solution overlay can be seen here. So even before we perform the assessment of each individual solution or application, we can already gain some considerable valuable insight just from performing this overlay. Firstly, it shows where there are multiple solutions for the same capability. The worst case of which we've seen was, believe it or not, 124 solutions to address the same capability. Where this capability is standardized, see video three, this is a waste that should be addressed in the target state. Note that where the capability is non-standardized, further investigation is required, as it may be correct and may not be waste. The next insight you can gain is where a solution only partially covers a capability or set of capabilities, often supplemented by spreadsheets or Access databases. In this case, you should definitely look for a more comprehensive or holistic solution in the target state. You can see gaps where there is no technology solution for a capability, which identifies more opportunities for greater automation that should be considered. Overlaying the issues from step one, the business intent gathering, you can clearly see hotspots that need to be addressed in the target state, and where possible should be considered for quick wins or early implementation in the roadmap or higher prioritization. The next aspect of the current state then is to assess each individual solution or application. As I said earlier, this could be done quantitatively or qualitatively, preferably qualitatively, unless there's a really good reason to do it quantitatively. For a qualitative assessment, all you gather is a general business and technical view of a solution, i.e. the business owner says it's not meeting their needs, you accept that at face value. Similarly, if the solution is no longer supported by the vendor and or is in a technology that's not as contemporary, then that's usually sufficient information to assume the solution needs to be replaced in the target state. Where a qualitative assessment is required, it is generally survey-based with a very large questionnaire tailored for the organization, which assesses the solution both from a business and technical perspective. Here we can see an example of the results for a business assessment of a single solution displayed on a spider diagram. And then we can roll all these up to display the business assessment of all solutions as shown here. Similar diagrams are produced for the technical assessments. All this assessment data can be summarized and communicated using a technology maturity assessment overlay on the business capability model. Again, an example of which is shown here. Finally, while an assessment of the current state of a technology is naturally critical important when developing a technology roadmap, any holistic transformational roadmap for an organization needs to consider the other facets of a capability. Any business capability covers the people, process, data, and technology that's required to deliver the services of that capability. Just as for technology, the other three facets can also be assessed qualitatively or quantitatively. Each of them produces its own maturity overlay as shown here. After applying a weighting to each facet, tailored for each capability, for example, the strategy management capability, people and data would likely be weighted higher than process or technology, while for accounts payable capability, it might be data and technology that are weighted the highest. This then results in an overall digital maturity assessment for each capability, an example of which is shown here. Together, this current state analysis gives you your perfect starting point. Thank you for your time. I hope it was of interest and value to you. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.